Put on your pink fedoras and get ready to fly. We saw the Deadly Mile High Club, so you know what that means.
A nigga grow a baby in his belly, rock a rhinestone vest while whipping Justin to Kelly, or maybe see a burlesque show with Nick Crow and take a boat with Speed to hitting cruise control. J-Man, Big Paul in the beautiful June, gonna take you from the goob all the way to the room. Ran the games in Street Fighter, helped to blow off steam, just a sucker punch the odd life of Timothy Green. Sharknado the Birdemic, how we staying alive, they call it in the badass and he's on the line, cranking 88 minutes cause they cool as ice, cause a bad Jim Varney looking kind of nice. Paul and June getting literal. Jason is getting laid. June is making sure all the monkey shots getting paid. They judge a bunch of movies while they're making the grade. Here's a real question for you. How did this get made? That's a good look, Haru.
What's that smell?
Hello, everybody, and welcome to How Did This Get Made's Matinee Monday. I'm Paul Scheer, and this is a look back at some classic episodes of How Did This Get Made that we have taken out of the vault and put back into the regular episode feed. So you can go listen to that episode whenever you'd like. But if you want to have a little sampler, a little appetizer, if you will, of the episode that we're talking about today, let me tell you all about it right now. The Deadly Mile High Club is Fatal Attraction in the sky. A teacher falls in love with her student and then tries to kill everyone in his life. The only difference is she is a flight instructor, which means she gets to kill people in the sky. I mean, this is like Lifetime movie greatness. Everything about it is amazing. From the job that this man has at a factory doing what we don't know. We think just moving boxes, to, like I mentioned earlier, a very sexy pink fedora. Plus, this movie, I think, is the only film in history to get the phrase, "Houston, we have a problem," wrong. They did it wrong. No one on set stopped and said, well, maybe not that. I think the one thing that you need to know about this is that the performance of Margaret is just absolute perfection. Here, take a listen to a little clip from this episode of The Deadly Mile High Club.
His wife literally says, like, how can you be a pilot? You have to be good at math and like and physics.
She's not wrong. She's not wrong.
She has no.
You guys, honestly, would you, if Paul, no offense, but if you said to me today, I want to fly a plane, I would, and I'm going to walk into this conversation as delicately as possible, but I would say that's absolutely reckless. And I don't trust you up there with your own life. And I don't trust you up there with the lives of others in that plane and innocent lives on the ground.
All right.
I think flying, I mean this honestly, I think flying, the act of flying, defying gravity, is not for amateurs.
Didn't we have this conversation, Jason? Like, you and I,
we did on a different show.
Okay, yes.
It's not a hobby to fly a plane.
I don't want to be a part-time pilot.
Harrison Ford, that.
It's not a hobby. You know what? When my friend, because we have friends who have planes, and I've been invited up, and my stance is, listen, you are too funny. You're too good as a comedian.
Yep.
You're too good at something.
Pick your lane.
You are good enough at this that you can't also be a good enough pilot. So that must mean I'm not interested in flying with a hobbyist.
Yeah, I don't want to see my internist show up at an improv show because he really cares about his improv group. Like, I want you to be dead down the middle. I operate on people, or I do improv comedy at night. Like, I don't want your passion to be anything else. I want you to be like,
I don't want my doctor to be like a pretty good jazz guitarist.
Yep. Nope.
You know, I don't want to come to your show, man.
Wait, we have had this conversation before.
Yeah, I think we've talked about
Leonardo da Vinci was an amazing artist and also a doctor.
Wait, oh,
sure.
Okay, sure. All right, well, that was in a time when you could
that's
do that.
That's a time when it was to be a doctor was to know someone's
to know, like,
humors.
Where the heart was.
Yeah, get some leeches and just make them bleed out. Yeah, like
was to be like, I think there's a spirit in his leg.
Yeah, that back then it was fine to be a couple of different things.
He was not a brain surgeon.
Yeah, no. Yeah, I would like to see a record of.
But no shade to Leonardo da Vinci. I mean, truly like an unparalleled genius in history, like a singular, one of the old, like a unique individual.
Well, the question then becomes, what do we think of John Travolta? Is he a better pilot or a better actor?
I mean, like, I'm going to be honest. If I was sitting on a plane and they were like, hey, everybody, great news. John Travolta is going to join us as a guest pilot. I would be like, ding, I'm ready to get off the plane.
I don't want it. I don't want it. I don't want it.
Harrison Ford has a death wish. I mean, he has crashed those planes a number of times now.
I guess maybe that's the reason why she survived. I mean, she's got Harrison Ford body. I mean,
I think actors who want to be pilots want the captive audience. I think it speaks to their desire to be like still the focus of some group of people's attention, and that they are the heroes of the day. Like when John Travolta is like, I can fly a 727 full of people. I'm like, you shouldn't.
Yeah.
This is irresponsible.
Yeah, don't buy
a
jet.
Something happens though. Yeah. I mean, something happens with celebrity where because so many people know them, because they feel like they have this position in the world, that people feel like they can do anything. It's really very strange. Meaning like run for president, they can do anything.
What if I said to you, like, guys, I just enrolled in medical school. Like, I'm still going to do all my acting stuff, but I'm doing my hours, and I'm going to be able to in a couple of years.
Kim Kardashian, like, right? She's going to school to be a lawyer.
Well, but by the way, here's
that,
the thing.
That I can kind of, I don't know.
I can get behind that 100%. And I have an interest in going to law school, so I'm just going to say that.
Okay,
right,
Jerry
now.
O'Connell. Jerry O'Connell, right after we finished Piranha, went to law school.
Well, did there are really? Certain things like law school, med school, like the system will decide whether you're ready to practice
right.
or not.
I guess, I guess so. Yeah.
With flying, there are a certain amount of hours you have to log before you get up there, and there is a system in place. However, there is, after you get those hours, you can go up recreationally willy-nilly. If you're doctor...
You can't be like, hey, I did my hours. I'm ready to to pull out some appendix.
And by the way, if you become a lawyer, you're not going to kill everybody and yourself by trying a case or dealing with a con.
That's not true. I mean,
depends on if it's a death penalty.
Wow.
Case.
Well, you think that like people are going to go right to death penalty cases? I guess maybe you're right.
I think Kim Kardashian could be trying death penalty cases within the next few
years. All right. Well, now you've laid down the gauntlet. Like, all right. Well, then I hope that she, and maybe this is the step in the right direction. The Kardashians are over.
She
Kardashians
has been working to get people off of death row.
Off of death row, sure. But not. Yeah. Okay. Sure.
Now that the Kardashians is wrapping up,
R.I.P.
Maybe
I'm
that is
quite upset
the next.
R.I.P.
Maybe that's the next show. You know, the next show is like Kim Kardashian. It's a law show where she is, you know, a lawyer, and I would watch that.
That was like that when they did that amazing Law and Order. A reality show. It was like the real Law and Order. It was
I didn't know about this.
It was a Dick Wolf produced show where they followed. It was just the real version of the show,
like a docuseries about that. Oh,
it was really good, but I guess not too good because it didn't last. But anyway, we've talked about this, so I guess we can all say that actor pilots are worse than actor musicians.
That's it for this week's episode of Matinee Monday. This is a really fun episode and one that I suggest you watch before you listen to the episode, because it really is a joy. How Did This Get Made is going to be in San Francisco in December. Go to hdtgm.com for tickets and information for all of our tour. And you go to tpublic.com/stores/hdtgm to find all the shirts that we make for these episodes. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, do all the things you like to do, or don't. It's okay. But I like you being here. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.